To me, the Swapmod is one of the most exciting new products in 3D printing right now. What the Swapmod essentially allows you to do is take your Bambu Lab A1 Mini and then have automatic plate switching and get that printer to mass produce, which I think is really cool. I actually attempted to make something similar with G-code a while ago. You can check that video out here, but honestly, I think this is so much better and so much better thought out. First, a quick double disclaimer. I did pay for this one with my own money. I just funded it on Kickstarter. I did contact the guy that makes these since he also lives in Germany, and I got an early sample to review it on this channel. So just so you know, I did get this early, but it's not sponsored. I bought this with my own money. And as I already said, this is a pre-production sample, so things might slightly change before you get your final model if you get it on Kickstarter. So now let's get into this box and see how all of this works. You get a lot of stuff with pre-assembled hardware. This already has a lot of screws and magnets and all the kind of stuff that would be really hard to make yourself. And some other stuff where you don't have to do as much, you just gotta print yourself to just keep costs down. But what I also like is that there is this packet full of screws that you actually have all the hardware you need to assemble the stuff for all the little plates you need. In addition to the kit, you also need more of these Bambu Lab build plates. I got 3 extra ones for my A1 Mini, giving me a total of 4 plates that I have that I can print in succession with this. I think this should be good for most of use cases, and if I want, I can always buy more. Then in the box is a QR code that's going to give you all the stuff that you have to print and also a quick guide on how to set everything up. And we'll get on that now. So I now have everything assembled. It wasn't too hard, but the guide has option for improvement. But you know, since this is a pre-production model, I think the guides might still be changed, and that's something that I'm gonna give feedback for, that I think, you know, a little bit of voiceover, a little bit of explanation would make this process 100 times easier, and that would be well appreciated. One important thing to note is that the Swapmod is not compatible if you have a different top, for example, like this handle, which I think is pretty popular. So I'm gonna have to find the original that I threw somewhere and reattach it for this point. Maybe you could get this to work, but for now, I just go stock to make sure that everything works. So I feel like these are the little way how life tests me. I put this on like a week ago and actually threw the original away because I thought, hey, I'll never need that again. And then right now for this mod, I need the original, or eventually I'll maybe make a version of this that works with that. But yeah, so I had to dig this out of the trash at home, but now I can build it back and we'll keep installing. So after around like 30 to 45 minutes of building, this thing is now fully set up, and I'm gonna do the self-test and then we'll see if everything works already. That first test actually went really well, so now I'll throw on a bunch of prints and let it do its thing overnight. Let's hope this works. It's the next day and everything went flawlessly. You can see here 1, 2, 3, and 4 prints, and yeah, that's so nice. I have to say I'm really pleasantly surprised. Normally getting something like this done is really finicky, and for this, I just installed it and now it works perfectly. Honestly, walking away on the first print for this overnight was risky, but it worked out perfectly, and yeah, honestly, so impressed by the system so far. So now that things are working, let me tell you a little bit more about the system. One thing that I immediately noticed is that when you install the Swapmod, the printer becomes a lot deeper. So it's like not wide, but just like deep. And this means that it gets a little difficult to place it normally on a desk. In terms of the depth, it still fit my desk, but whenever a print would get ejected, it would just fall straight off the desk and land on the ground, which was super loud and also might break or damage your prints. But honestly, it's nothing too bad. For now, I just placed it sideways on my desk, but eventually I just put it normally and then make something to catch the prints that fall off. Also, I want to mention that for now, I just put a couple of prints on every plate, but this was just a test run to see if everything's working. With this mod, you can fully fill each plate all the way through. This is a big benefit compared to other methods where, for example, you take the print head to push the prints off, but you always need like 5 or whatever centimeters at the back for the print head to lower and then push things off. With this, since the whole print bed is moved, you need no space and you can just fill everything to the brim, which is actually nice. Also, with this, since the full print bed is moved, as I said, you don't need to wait for the hotbed to cool down and prints release so they can be pushed off, but you just instantly push them off with the bed and can start printing, which really saves time if you're mass producing, which is honestly nice. But besides these little explanations, I want to tell you how the whole process worked for me, and especially how it software-wise works. Honestly, it's really nice because it's super easy. You take all of your 3D files as normal and load them in either Bambu Slicer or Orca Slicer. There you can do all the settings as usual and do all your slicing as you would. You separate things onto the different build plates in the slicer, which is really easy to do. When you're all done and all happy with everything, you then just export all plates onto your computer. Swapmod has its own website where you can upload the files for all of those plates. And honestly, it has a really nice and clean user interface. You will see all your plates displayed that you're gonna print. You can easily change the order if you want to. Also, for each plate individually, you can select if you want to print it once or multiple times. And there's also an expert settings where you can print all the plates multiple times. So there's really a lot of options to get you mass producing really fast. Once you have everything set up in the website, it shows you at the top how long it's gonna take and how much filament it's gonna need, which is a really nice overview. From there on, you just need to export that file, which is gonna give you another 3MF file, which you just put into a Bambu Studio or Orca Slicer again. Once you're in the slicer, the preview does look a little bit janky, but that's just because the slicer doesn't support the plate swapping in between. So it will just show all of the models that you're printing in one place and in one plate. So it might look like things might be in the same place, overlapping, or if you're printing the same thing multiple times, you'll only see it once. But don't worry about that too much, because just check if the overall print time is pretty much what the website told you, and from there on out, you just send it to the printer and wait. From what I gather, the Swapmod system can hold up to 10 plates, so there's plenty of room to keep printing for a long time. Also, if you ever run out of a print plate and the printer still has another job to do, the A1 Mini actually detects that there's no print plate on the bed and then stops. This is really nice because it's just error preventing and nothing can go wrong there. Another nice thing is that all of this works without problem with your AMS too. So you can either, of course, just print multicolored models and then print multiple plates of that. But also, if you have a model that is separate into different colored parts, you can print each color on one plate, meaning you'll have to do a lot less color switching in between, which is gonna save a lot of time and also filament. So hearing all these positive things, who's this system really for? Well, you might think this is just for people with a print farm or Etsy sellers that print tons of prints. And you're right, but I think it's also really great for hobbyists. I often start prints to run overnight, but when the printer is done in the middle of the night, it just sits there and does nothing. With this system, I can just build up a little print queue and it'll just jump to the next thing and keep printing. Honestly, this is so nice and would allow me to print a lot more and get projects done faster. And the other thing is, this mod comes at a price point that really makes it affordable for pretty much everybody, I say. On Kickstarter right now, you're paying around $70 plus shipping. You still need to factor in the cost for additional build plates that you need, but these cost around $20 each, so all in all, I think you're gonna pay around $130-$150 all in. One thing to note is that this currently can't be sold to the US for some legal reasons, and in the Kickstarter stage, it's also selling to not all the countries for some shipping stuff. All of this will be addressed in the future, and there's an update plan that's gonna go to all countries in Q1 or Q2 of 2025. I'm gonna put a link in the description where you can sign up for updates if you're interested. So with all of this good and positive stuff, I also wanted to mention some things that I would love to see improved and some just constructive criticism. As I said before, I would love for the guides to be improved. There is one that already has voiceover, and I like that a lot better than just seeing it being done and not being able to follow along or not being able to get that extra bit of information. Right now, most of them are just a quick video of someone doing it with no explanation, no voiceover, no nothing. And that was really hard for me to follow sometimes. There's one that had some voiceover and I like that a lot better. So hopefully more of that's coming once things are actually nearing production. And yeah, the next one is that I hope that the system becomes more open to other ways of using it. I would love if they release the full G-code for swapping the plates. Like this, you could make a custom printer profile and just put it in the end G-code there. So if I just manually do one, then still at the end, it would swap the plate to a new one. And whenever I wanted to start a new print, it would already be ready without having the whole print queue thing that it's doing right now. This would just offer a little bit more flexibility in using it. I actually got to talk to Andre, the creator of Swapmod, at FarmNext in Frankfurt and talk to him about this one. And he has an even better idea because he's going to make a Bambu Lab print profile that you can use from your phone and from whenever. So even if your print isn't made for this at all, you can manually trigger the print place switch and then print the next thing. And I think that's just genius. It really shows how much effort and thought he puts into the whole thing. Also, if you have that G-code, you could implement it with a print queue server, like simplyprint.io, which is really cool. There you could just have that to switch in between prints, and then you'd have the system fully integrated into a print queue server. So I could always add new things whenever I feel like it. Right now, you have to decide once, go through the website, and then that's the thing you're printing. With something like this website, I could just decide whenever I want to chuck something new in the queue, and it would just keep printing until the plates run out. And that would give a lot more flexibility, especially I think for people that run print farms and have their management systems going. Another idea where I don't know if it's possible would be for the little bracket to go on the print plate to be double-sided or reversible. I have double-sided print plates with one smooth and one textured side, and I would just love to just be able to flip it around and use it however I want. Right now, I'd have to take the screw off, flip it, and then screw it back together, which still works, but honestly, I'd prefer if this was just a double-sided thing, which would make things a lot easier still. And lastly, but this is just a wish for the future, is for a system like this to also come to the full-sized A1, because with that you can still print a bunch of different things that are bigger, and I would love that eventually, but it's not a flaw of this system per se. So all in all, I have to say I love this system. I'm really impressed by Andre and the work he's done with this product. So if you're someone who prints a lot, I can only recommend the system. For example, for me, as I want to build out my Gridfinity system, I think this is going to be a lifesaver. Definitely check out the description down below for a link to the Kickstarter page for the Swapmod and also for my Bambu Lab affiliate link. It really means the world to me if you use my affiliate link and support the channel through that. And if you really want to know how annoying and hard it can be to do something like this yourself, you can watch this video where I automate my Ender 3v3. It was definitely a lot more work and didn't go remotely as well, but it was still a fun build. So thanks so much for watching this video, and I hope I'll see you in the next one.